Friends, welcome to worship as we celebrate God's presence here at Topsail United. I'm Reverend Kathy Brett, for those who are watching online, I'm not sure who I am, and our musician is Madeleine Godet, and we welcome you. You are here in person, and those of you who are wherever you may be, we again give thanks that through God's Spirit and God's grace, we are united. For the life and work of our congregation and pastoral, I invite you to turn to the bulletin. I'm guessing it's page 4. There's a whole lot of announcements there, but we'll go through them. Next Sunday is October 31st. We will commemorate All Saints Day. And as I said last week, you're more than welcome to come dressed as your favorite saint. But all kidding aside, we will commemorate those saints of the faith who have inspired us personally. And if you would like to have someone honored specifically in the service, so we'll be a time for lighting candle and remembrance, please contact the church office by email or phone by Wednesday so we can compile the list. Our auction is continuing on, and you may know today some beautiful things around me particularly. Some items that are on auction. Sorry, as in past years, I know people have been able to come and view them more directly, but at least you get a sense. We have some beautiful artwork, preserves, you have clothing, knitted goods, lots of gift cards, and wonderful things. So the bidding ends this Thursday, and that is Thursday at 11 p.m. So please have a look. It's online. You can get the link from our Facebook page, website, and if you have any issues, then just call us at the office. Also, I really should say thank you. I challenged last week to fill the shopping cart, and it is filled because there's even food on the bottom there. So thank you so much for those who have donated, and I know there's donations of money there as well, which is much needed at our food bank. So thank you so much as a sign of our willingness to help with the food insecurity of people around us. Reminder of recycling bags, recycling bags for our youth. On November the 2nd, there will be a covenant service with the Reverend James Rabcroft and at St. James United, and we're welcome to attend. And our First Don Eastern Edge Regional Council are holding learning events this year online, and it's a series of like lunch and learns. And so there are 4 upcoming ones, so you can go online also with First on Eastern Edge webpage and register for them. It's very easy, there's no charge. And our presenters, the first one is Reverend Faith March McCush, Susan Shepherd from St. James and Portugal Cove Pastoral Charges, and our moderator, Reverend Dr. Richard Bott, will be doing the last one. So please, and also a reminder of those who would like to know how to give to our congregation and the work that we do, then please, you may do so by e-transfer, also through our church or through PAR. And if you need more information, please contact the office, and we give thanks for all who have all the gifts that have been given and shared in our congregation. Whew, I think, and right, a few more things there. I invite you to read at your leisure. And also, is there anything anybody else has to share? I have a big piece of news I heard this morning. on Friday, our own Madeleine received her, convocated with her master's in music. So congratulations. Awesome. Anyone else? Anything to share? Or if not, I'm going to light the Christ candle as a reminder to us that Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace, is with us, guiding our hearts and our lives in the ways of peace. Before we go further, I'd like to acknowledge that the territory in which we gather is the ancestral homelands of the Beothuk. We also recognize that the island of Newfoundland is the traditional homelands of the Beothuk and the Mi'kmaq peoples, and that the original people of Labrador are the Innu and Inuit. We strive for respectful relationships with all the peoples of this province as we search for collective healing and true reconciliation and honor this beautiful land together. And friends, today we recognize that it is Peace Sabbath, and so this theme will run throughout the service as Madeleine begins that for us today. Silence and what silence says to you today. As we are together praying for peace, let us be truly with each other. Let us pay attention to our breathing. Let us be relaxed in our bodies and our minds. Let us be at peace with our bodies and our minds. Let us return ourselves and become wholly ourselves. Let us maintain a half smile on our faces. Let us be aware of the source of being common to us all and to all living things. invoking the presence of the great compassion. Let us fill our hearts with our own compassion towards ourselves and toward all living things. And let us pray that all living beings realize that they are all brothers and sisters, all nourished from the same source of life. Let us pray that we ourselves cease to be the cause of suffering to each other. And let us plead with ourselves to live in a way which will not deprive others, other living beings of air, water, food, shelter, or the chance to live. With humility, with a mere awareness of the existence of life and of the sufferings that are going on around us, let us pray for the establishment of peace in our hearts and on earth. And let us now pray as we turn to our opening prayer. Because you made the world and intended it to be a good place, and called its people your children, because when things seemed at their worst, you came in Jesus to bring out the best in us. So graciously, God, we gladly say, goodness is stronger than evil, love is stronger than hate, light is stronger than darkness, and truth is stronger than lies. Because confusion can reign inside us, despite our faith, because anger, tension, bitterness, and envy distort our vision, because our minds sometimes worry small things out of proportion, and because we do not always get it right, we want to believe. Goodness is stronger than evil. Love is stronger than hate. Light is stronger than darkness. Truth is stronger than lies. Because you have promised to hear us, and we are able and are able to change us, and are willing to make our hearts your home, we ask you to confront, control, forgive, and encourage us. Then let us cherish in our hearts that which we proclaim with our lips. Goodness is stronger than evil. Love is stronger than hate. Light is stronger than darkness. Truth is stronger than lies. Hear our prayer and change our lives until we illustrate your love and grace, O God, who makes all things new. Amen. Friends, the good news is that through our God and the gift of grace given to us through Jesus Christ, and by the bond of love that joins us to the Holy Spirit, we know that God is the source of goodness, love, light, and truth. Let us take these things to heart and know that God does indeed forgive us, offers us grace and new opportunities to be agents of peace and love. Thanks be to God. Amen. And friends, may the peace of Christ, the Prince of Peace, be with you. Let's take a moment just to kind of nod or wave to our neighbors as a sign of sharing of peace with each other.
For today's music of ministry, I'm going to play Rachmaninoff's Prelude, Opus 32, number 5, in G.
Thank you, Madeline. And again, congratulations. We are blessed. Friends, let us prepare ourselves to hear God's word as we join together in our prayer of illumination as printed in your order of service. Your word, O God, is filled with messages of peace. Open not just our ears, but also our hearts and minds, so that we may truly listen to you. Guide us to be agents of hope and peace in the world. Amen.
In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised up above the hills. People shall stream to it, and many nations shall come and say, Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between many peoples, and shall arbitrate between strong nations far away. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not go up, lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. But they shall all sit under their own vines and under their own fig trees, and no one shall make them afraid. For the mouth of the Lord of hosts has spoken. Reading now from Romans chapter 12. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we who are many are one body in Christ. And individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in the proportion to faith. Ministry in ministering. The teacher in teaching. The exhorter in exhortation. The giver in generosity. The leader in diligence, compassionate in cheerfulness. Now that I've read all that, we'll start where I'm supposed to start. Sorry. My markers weren't very clear. So now we will start with, let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope, to patience in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peacefully with others. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, "Vengeance is mine. I will repay, says the Lord." Know if your enemies are hungry. Feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. The word of the Lord.
Doreen, you are most graciously forgiven. As I hope I am too. And I have to say, God love Doreen. She was the person who checked our vaccine passports today. So thank you so much. And there was a couple of little glitches, but not bad. So thank you so much. And thank you for reading. And you know what? It might not have been the one that was prescribed, but I think they were right words for us too. So, no need to apologize. I kind of do. I was remiss at the beginning in welcoming home today Heather, our own Heather Pranholm is here. And we're so glad you're here. And Heather is serving at Fortune United. And we are happy you're at home this weekend, and with our mom, Reverend Wendy is here with us too. So welcome, welcome. You'll notice that there's a third reading of scripture. I have decided I would read it a little later in my reflection. Okay? And just hope I don't forget it, as I have lost the page. So don't feel bad, Marie. When I was a student at Munn, and for those, I don't know, anybody might be watching who don't know what Munn is, because I don't think people refer to it much as that anymore, but Memorial University, I noticed one day that someone was putting up posters for an organization, Project Plowshares. Anybody ever hear of them? No, a few people here. Well, the person I was with my own group of friends, and I guess our own little posse, and I noticed this person putting it up, and I was kind of curious, because I saw signs up, about Project Plowshares, and I was kind of curious, but now I will have to tell you, and the person who was putting up the signs was, now, some of your day, people were hippies, right? Well, my day it was more punk. This was like the early to mid 80s. And the person putting up the sign was wearing jeans with the knees out long before they became cool or cost $100 to buy. And I was kind of curious, but of course my friends, you know, you got your own little group of friends, and of course everybody starts saying, oh my, just look at him. And I have to say, I'll be very honest, I followed my friends. Even though I was kind of curious, and even though I thought the person was pretty courageous to dress outside the normal, and wear makeup outside the normal, I wasn't as courageous to go find out really what it was. For me, it was safer just to go along with my own friends. There's security there. Now, years later, as I became more involved in the church, probably developed another kind of posse, I realized that Project Plowshares is an organization established through the Canadian Council of Churches and one of the 9 churches or denominations that support it and are a very big part of it is, can you guess who it is? The United Church. And when I realized that, part of me thought, Mike, I could have been involved in the church earlier than what I was. And part of me thought, I could have informed myself earlier than I did, because the Project Plowshares, it's an organization that began in the mid-70s, who were dedicated to peace and initiatives of peace. And back in that day, we were still in the midst of Cold War and for the elimination of nuclear weapons. And yeah, wonderful, organization to be involved in. Probably just as wonderful might have been to be a punk at the time too. But I don't know if you're like me, and I'd like to say that it's the only time in my life that I let my own prejudices, my own wanting to be safe with people I knew instead of stepping out to learn something new. I would like to say it's the only time that I ever did that. But I can't. I can't. And the plowshares, have you heard what from Joel this morning? Joel is prophesying about a day of peace. A day when the weapons of war will be taken away and beaten into plowshares, made into something new, made into something that will create life on earth in fertile fields. Something that was used for destruction can be used for something that will build up. And I hope, and I believe, that even in ourselves, those fears will give way to places of courage to work for something better. That we all have our place for peace. I was always very naive that, you know, war and peace was something far away. But I think I've come to realize that peace is something that we work on as a practice with ourselves, with each other, and further out into the world. But it's not there just yet. I want to share other words of hope and other words of peace, of getting to that peace. These are the words of Jeremiah. I will tell you, this is my favorite piece of scripture. And when I tell friends that, is that your favorite scripture? I say, yes, yes. This is what Jeremiah prophesies. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them to the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them. I will put my law within them, and I will write it upon their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, know the Lord, for they shall all know me. From the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord, for I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sins no more. The day is surely coming when we know deep within us. That peace, that love of God, that we will live peacefully. And I know I continue to need work to work on that. I'm guessing a few others. But in the meantime, God has given us gifts to help us realize that. The gift of Jesus Christ, who offered and spoke of peace from his first Sermon on the Mount to his last meal with his friends, and he offered that peace again when he rose. That is our assurance. And let's take to heart words that we've heard in Scripture this morning that tells us how to live with each other. And I think when we take all this in, when we truly know it in our hearts, and we truly live for peace, us here, those of you watching at home, and people all around the world, then we will know peace, and we will know God. Thanks be to God. Amen. As I said earlier, we are thankful for the gifts that we receive here, and we offer thanks to you, and we offer thanks to God, and we ask God to bless them and us, the givers. Let us pray. Accept our gifts, O God, for your work of peace. We offer them because we know that change is possible. We know we can make a difference in this world when we believe in your love and compassion. We seek your blessing upon our gifts and upon us as we work for peace and justice. Amen. And friends, let us sing our commitment as we sing together the prayer of St. Francis of Assisi, "Make me a channel of your peace."
Oh,
And for those of you in particular who are watching from home and can see them, members of our choir are socially distanced but sort of together. And so thank you. And send them very soon. You'll be in the back too. Friends, as we have just prayed, in the words of St. Francis, let us again join our hearts in prayer as we come to God. O God, we thank you for your gifts of word and life that promote peace. Peace within ourselves, with each other, and with the world around us. Thank you for the words of the prophets, those of scripture, those closer to us, for their urgings of peace. We thank you for Project Plowshares and their now modern prophetic voices, challenging us with the hope of peace. And so, as we give thanks that we live in a place of peace, or a country of peace, we pray for those who long for peace. For the places in the world, in Afghanistan, in Palestine, in Israel, Somalia, and all the places where there is conflict, we pray for deep peace, that hearts may be opened to you. And we pray for those who long for peace within their families, with their neighbors, and that right relationships can become the norm. And we pray for those who long for peace within themselves. Help them to know their true worth as you do, and to love themselves as you do. We pray that your peace will permeate this world. And we pray for those in governments who make decisions that they keep in mind the ways of peace and harmony with each other. And we pray today for those whose lives are in turmoil, for those who are grieving. We pray for solace. And for those who are ill, we pray for comfort and healing. And we know that there may be dis-ease within ourselves. And we know that we have people and places and situations for which we long for peace and resolution. So, O God, we bring them to you now from the silence of our hearts. O God, we pray they may feel your peace, your love, your comforting grace. O God, we pray that you will truly make us agents of peace, dedicated to your ways, and dedicated to serve our neighbors with love and care in the way of Jesus Christ. And so we join our prayer with his prayer of life and peace as we say it together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Friends, our closing hymn is All the Way My Savior Leads Me. Son of God, the Prince of Peace, be with you and bless you today and always. Amen.
Thank you.